When I say teach, I mean create, to activate humility. Actually, he came on this earth, first of all, to create a space within us, by removing the hurdles of the ego. Hurdles of it. He had to talk of humility that time. Because Romans were ruling and they were very arrogant, very crude, uncouth, underdeveloped, we should say, not at all evolved. Like you can say some of the animals which came into being and were thrown out of the evolutionary process later on. So they were useless, too aggressive or too big for their size or some sort of a thing like that. In the same way Romans were. If you see their body, even now, painted sometimes, you find that it was not like a human body, but like some animal. Muscles and all that was very good. There was no softness, no roundishness. on their faces. So this ego of Romans affected everyone whom they ruled. Because when you have somebody as an ideal before you, and always people see who dominates them, and there is such person becomes their ideal. So you start imbibing that kind of a character within yourself. You see somebody who is condescending, you also become suddenly condescending. You see somebody who is very egoistical and tries to show off, you also put up there. You see this every day happen, that a boss comes in who is a very, very airy person. Everybody in the office is there. And that's how Romans affected the people in those days by creating their own ideas. People thought they are the ideas, they are the best. Because they had produced results according to them. They were so powerful. They thought this was the power. And that's why they followed their method, many people who were not even Romans. Another humbler group was affected because they were hurt. Their ego was hurt. So they became equally violent in the sense that they were so touchy that you could not say anything to them. They would just come and bark, frightened. This kind of character is very dangerous also, because that gives you some sort of very bad disease. Can give you leprosy. People develop leprosy with that kind of character. If you develop a barking temperament of a nature by which you just jump at people, now become absolutely sort of shattered. And the leprosy is a disease of the nerves. Those people who always keep themselves under such pain and jump at every person who comes along are very dangerously placed as far as their nerves are concerned. And then a horrible type of virus, you know that, which creates leprosy, attacks these nerves, can attack, because they are very vulnerable, this kind of people who jump, whatever. That's why there was so much leprosy in that small little place. There were so many lepers, because their nerves are shattered. In those circumstances, Christ was born. But he was not only born just for Romans or for anyone, but he was born for the whole world. Because ego had started growing in human beings at that time and had developed quite a lot as far as the Romans were concerned. And that demarcated the way human beings were going on. So they had to be controlled, first of all. And Christ had to come at a time where a balance. So the first thing that was said about Christ throughout in all these music and songs you have heard now is that peace on earth. He came to create peace on earth. That's only possible when you are in balance, first of all. Secondly, when you are realized. Both things should be. If only you get your realization and there is no balance in you, there cannot be. But peace never means in any way is a personality that recedes, runs away from situation, escaping. It does not want to face the reality. Never means that. Christ is pictured very differently from what he was. He was the strongest personality, the healthiest man. and he would not stand any nonsense. Nobody could take liberties. But he would not himself take liberties. Of course, no question. Extremely compassionate, extremely kind, but very powerful. This is the balance. So he came on this earth to create peace within us. On this earth, there is no peace. Why? What's wrong? It's only the human beings are wrong. Well, within yourself, who is violent? Human beings are violent to each other. Ego develops subtler ways. Then provocative ways started coming up also from the super ego. Sly method from the super ego. The conflict started. And at that time, to overcome that conflict, the best thing was create a space in Agya, in the center, in thoughtless awareness. That's how Christ had to come on this earth. The birth is very, very symbolic. Because he is nothing but Chaitanya, he is nothing but the word as you call it, Logos. I don't know what all words you have got in language. The Shabda is the color. The Omkara. He was to be born in this way. Because he had no body. And the subtlest of subtle he had to be. Because the work was very subtle. Sukshma. That's why he was born like that. It's very poetic to see him lying down in a manger. That look at him. The king of heaven should herself understand. Don't go near that. So the story of his birth was very interesting. That he came in a humble being. Because people were so proud of their money, so arrogant, because of their power that they had. Even today, all the Christian nations are like that. Surprisingly, Christian nations should be so arrogant and so power drunk and think the end of themselves because they are afflicted. Think of the Christian nations being very poor, do you think they would have had racial problems? They don't have racial problems with Arabs. Not at all. As simple as that. No problem with Arabs. They have no race. Arabs have no race. They have money. Money race. Those people who hanker after money are only bowing down to money. They have no respect for anything else but for money. Those who have money and think of money are another lot which is going to go out of the circulation of evolution. That's going out already. The second lot is the one which was like Romans. They had a fall. They all finished because they were power drunk. They drank away. Their civilization completely finished off. They are out.
You see in Portugal, you will be amazed, it's happening there. The ego of Portuguese was so great, you can't believe that that first country is a desolate country. There's nothing now. Huge buildings, which you see. And you know they must have been rich once upon a time. And there's nothing left with them except for their antique shops, which are never open. This kind of an ego is again revived. And that revival came up, imagine, in the name of Christ. Imagine. They purchased people to be converted as Christians. They gave them money. It's all money, money proposition, money enterprise going on. Jews the same, then the Christians the same. He was born in a manger. For a little child to be put in a manger by the Mahalakshmi. It's too much. See how symbolic it is, Mahalakshmi. Not Lakshmi, but Mahalakshmi. To put the child in the manger. No place. We have at least Jaisham Road, Warwick Road, Lambam Gardens, Brompton Square. But the child was born and was put in the manger. The humblest thing in this world is a manger. The humblest of all, a crib. The highest is put in the manger. So, what do we do? We think we should also sleep in the manger, we become like Christ. There are people who believe in such nonsensical things. They think that, you see, if they have all the money, they drink, they do all kinds of things, you see. I met one man one day, he was all drunk, lying near a church, saying, I am Christ, I am Christ. He must have got this idea that he is lying there because he is very humble. This kind of ridiculous caricature of the whole beautiful symbol is followed everywhere. So the arrogant and the egotistical might say that why, if he was the king, why was he born in the manger? Why was he kept in the manger? Everybody will have their own concept. Even there are people in India who are stupid people, not wise, who say that you must have done lots of bad karmas to be born like that. Because to them, karmas give you more money. Means God is not so unintelligent. If you do good karmas, you become men of God. You become seekers. You get the blessings of God by your good karma. You become religious people, not money people who can go to pubs and waste their lives. This is the idea they have got, that by doing good karma you become rich and become even worse for next life. Some people may believe that. But he never did any karma. He was in a karma. So no question of his punishment and all that, it was just a drama. But very symbolic it is. Now see, a little child put in the manger, no comfort. Can there be a comfort in manger? Think like that. All the Christian nations are after their comforts. Aren't we? What we think is not comfortable. Should be comfortable. Christians should never seek comfort. That is one of the messages of Christ. But if they seek comfort, then they are away from Christ. Because he was born in a mess. No comfort was provided for him. But that doesn't mean that you should assume some sort of a funny habitation. It doesn't mean that also. I mean, I have to tell the other side of it. Copying him is not the way. It's not the way by copying him that you will become Christ, but by imbibing his qualities within you. I have known people who live in a big star, but once they get to a better life, they want everything else. So imbibing the quality of humility and adjustment. Humility and adjustment. Anywhere you are put, anytime, very particular about time. If somebody has to come at 10 o'clock, and if he has to do a job, if it is he delayed by 5 minutes, he starts breaking all the heavens. He can't bear it. 5 minutes he has to wait. And if he has to wait 10 minutes, he's out for a pub. Finished. He cannot pacify himself unless until he takes a drink. This is the situation of a volcanic human mind. So the peace has to come. Oh, if you seek comfort, you'll become lazy lumps. You'll sleep off. You'll be lotus eaters. But if you not seek comfort, then peace will come. Because for our own comfort, for our selfish comfort of this body, we torture everybody. The other day only I was telling that only in the Western countries it is so, not in India. If somebody is sleeping even till 12 o'clock, you cannot wake up that person. It's a irreligious act. I mean, in India, anybody who sleeps after 6 o'clock, he'll feel ashamed of himself to be sleeping that time. He'll be apologetic the whole day and he'll say that, oh God, I'm sorry. It's regarded as sinful to sleep so late as 6 o'clock in the morning. I mean, any country like that. So comfort has no end. There's no end to it. Comfort crawls upon you. What is comfort? Let us see. Very simple. In Christ's symbolic life is very deep significance in this. That comfort is nothing but the matter overpowering the spirit. You see that point? If you are sitting on a chair, then you can't sit on the ground. If you are sitting on a sofa set, you can't sit on a chair. If you are sitting on a velvet, then you cannot sit in an ordinary thing. Is the matter always overpowering the spirit? And he was the spirit. What does it matter to him? Whether it's straw or anything? It is unsurmountable. Nothing can dispute the spirit of these material things. I mean, the matter otherwise will take over. That is the thing one has to understand. That he was the spirit. And if you have to become the spirit, first of all, try to give up your comfort. Lash your body a little bit. I'm sorry, on a Christian temple. Because he was also lashed that way. If you see on the day he was born, for a mother to put the child in a crib that was a manger is too much of a sacrifice. How much you want to do for your children? Dress them up properly, do this, do that. But the child was to be put in the manger, was put in the manger, just for you people to learn that comfort crawls on the spirit. We always seek the comfort. This one thing is the message to all of us. If you seek the bath, your room, I must have a bathroom attached to that. Again, comfort. What about my wife? Where is she going to sleep? She'll sleep as others are sleeping. And you'll sleep as others are sleeping. Nobody is going to die. Of that be sure. I can assure you. Sahaja Yoga is very hard thing that way, you see. Very few people die once they come to Sahaja Yoga. Some of them should. But they don't. They continue. They go on giving realization. They go on doing everything. Still they continue. They escape all the accidents, escape all the problems, and they continue. But this is a short time which must be used. It's a very, very concrete thing I wanted to tell you today. It's nice to talk of Christ's birth, be happy about it, sing songs, go into a mood like that, but really I tell you, it's a very symbolic thing for all of us to know that He slept in a man. And the another symbolism is that what did we offer Him? What did this world offer Him at that time? The another symbolism is that they offered Him a mansion. Are we going to do the same to our mother? This is one thing one has to know. Manger is, after all, is all right. It doesn't catch us anything. It has no left nabi, right nabi, nothing. It doesn't have all these problems. There are no thorns. There's no agya. There's nobody screwing up into your stomach. Suddenly you feel, oh God, don't want to see. So you are the thistles in that manger, which have to be soft to give comfort to Christ. You have to become so soft and so sweet, so clean and pure, because a new babe is going to be put in the manger. You are the kushas, is the thistle. And for a yogi, the kushasana is the one. He sits on the kusha. So he was a yogi, came on the kusha. Alright. But now what about you? To receive him in the manger, this is the manger. The mother is preparing the manger to make the child feel very happy and comforted. The thistle, adamance, obstinacy, harshness, ugliness, all must be struck down. It's very symbolic, it's very symbolic, I must say, his birth. Why, don't you think, why was he born like that? People might give any amount of interpretation, but I know because I've done it. I'm trying to soften. I'm trying to mold. Sometimes I have to be harsh with you. Sometimes I have to be angry with you. Sometimes I have to tell you off. Just now, there are some who are catching so much on the world that my stomach is screwing up. It's all right with me, because I'm supposed to be that. I'm so fortunate that I have to face all that. What about Christ within us? You are not going to be happy with yourself, with your being, with your spirit, unless and until you create a manger of very soft things. You yourself,
you are not going to enjoy.
You think that by justifying your egos, by justifying your arrogance, by justifying all that you are doing to each other, some people are busy making money out of Sergio, some people are busy deceiving others, some are telling lies, some are creating problems, some are beating wives, and some wives are provocating husbands. What is all this going on? You are creating a beautiful manger for Christ. Create the peace on earth. We have to be peaceful. To be peaceful, one has to be humble. This is the message of Christ. Humble. If you become humble, peace will come. Humble is a good word. I don't know if it explains what it means. Humble means not asking for your own comfort, but comfort of others. When others are before you, that is humility. It's not, thank you very much. You kill somebody and then tell to the dead person, I'm sorry, I killed you. Finished. In English language is over. Once you have said, I'm sorry, finished. Yes, I know. And the another is, I know. Why did you do it? I know. Finished. If he knows, then it's all right. Then there is no punishment. No. You don't know. You are all spirit, so you have to be chiseled out, all right, that's my job. You have to be cleaned out, that's my job, all right. Kundalini awakening is my job, I agreed. But maintenance is yours. On the contrary, sometimes I feel, because I do all this, the maintenance is good, very, very good. Like in India, I see some people try to help us by giving us money. We didn't earn the money ourselves. You see, somebody donated money and they built some well. All our dilapidated were fixed. Free gift. Nobody wants to look after it. It's human nature. If you don't work hard for your maintenance and just leave it to mother, oh, she will cure us. Let us continue what we want to do. She's coming after all. She's going to look after us. We'll lag behind. That's why my presence can be sometimes, in a way, not so fruitful. My presence in England is put up to a point. And afterwards, it should not be there for some. I love you very much, you know that very much. England is my heart. You have to be here. And this Christmas I wanted to celebrate. And a New Year. Just out of my own desire. But I have to make you understand that you have to work harder and harder to keep yourself clean. Get rid of your problems. Come up. Do not say, that yes, it is like this, mother, all the time you are reporting to me. Still, mother, I am catching. See now, this is happening. As if it's a boastful thing to say. I will get all right. I have to be all right. Now, mother has gone. Let me show her when I come back. When I once went to Bombay, Rahul Bhai did not come to see me for 7 days. When she was in Bombay, she had arrived. So I asked him, what's the matter? Is she keeping all right? If she's all right, then why didn't she come to see me? I was thinking, what's the matter? She came to see me after 7 days. She said, mother, I'm sorry I didn't come to see you because I was caught up this time. Wanted to cleanse myself before showing my face to you. So cleansing is to be done. Maintenance is to be done. Raising of the Kundalini, collectivity, collectivity. look after each other. You have to only support Sahajogis and not others, outsiders. They are outsiders, they are not us. We are Sahajogis, and those who try to support others are no more Sahajogis. They get out of Sahajoga would be better for us. Whatever we are among ourselves. Outsiders are outsiders. We have to love each other. We have to respect each other as well. Nobody has to say anything harsh things to each other. No. Be kind, loving, affectionate. Curb down your tongue. Be humble. Humility. Humility is the thing one has to be. Write it down with big words. Be humble. Be humble. Be humble. And when you become humble, such peace will reign. And you will feel so nice. Being humble, there's nothing wrong. Christ has gone to this extent to say that somebody slaps on this face, you turn the other. Be humble. With Romans, there was no other way out. There was no other way out. What? He preached humility. Throughout, he preached humility. You be humble to each other, that's all. You need not be humble to others, because no one can now torture the saints. It's over. That situation is over. But you be humble to each other. Humble in your demands of life. That doesn't mean that you should become people, just keep it there. That you become people of strange characters, you see. That doesn't mean that. You should be decent, with decorum, as Christ was when he was born. But you should be humble. Try to mold your body. Make them lighter, in the sense that you can sit anywhere, you can move anywhere, you can lie everywhere. You are all young. Adjust yourself. If somebody has one room, if it's all right, doesn't matter. I can live in the corridor. Don't worry. But they will be first jumping, I've seen that, to the room which has the attached bath. How many of you have rooms with attached bath? Let's see. Raise that. Living in the ashram. Better give up. Better give up. See now. Better give up. All of you give up your rooms and stay in rooms which are shared. Well, it's all right for you not to share because you are husband and wife. But need not ask for attached bath. Comforts are to be given up for others, not for. You should make others comfortable, not yourself. Sometimes I am surprised at human beings how they allow others to eat anything. The way they are, self-centered, is something surprising. But after Sahaja Yoga, you change. You enjoy giving comfort to others, saying comforting words to others, sweet things to others. You enjoy that. Christ was given a crib of a manger, and he came to comfort you, to give you peace, and he came as a savior. Can you imagine the contrast? You are the saviors of the whole universe now. I see you as saints, but you cannot be selfish. You cannot be comfortable. You have to be like Christ. He used to live wherever he lived. He lived in Florence, he lived anywhere. Just working hard for people. He would never even have his food sometimes. He lived under all circumstances. Under all conditions. He never asked for any comfort, nothing. He was a carpenter, he never even used it. He used a glove. Here you must have gloves. You must have socks, you must have shoes, you must have a shaving, you must have never shaved it. That doesn't mean you grow your beard. But he was a very clean person. He lived with a minimum of minimum. That's what one has to do, is to reduce him. You know, I have everything that one can see. But I can live with a minimum of minimum. I can live with 2 sides. And sometimes with 1. You should be able to live with minimum of minimum. That's the point. And that is what one has to learn from his life, that we are the saviors today. And savior lived just like a humble person, very elite in his behavior, very dignified. He was not like a beggar going hey, like that. Some of them are, you are like that also. You go about like this. When you talk like this, you go about. That's not the way. Dignity, with your magnificence, with your gravity, move about. Actually, those who are really great, those who are the real emperors, do not need anything. What can dominate them? Tell me. If you are the emperor of this world, if you know you are the queen of this world, what is more important? What comfort can dominate? What material thing can charm? Such a person, because that person is above, that's Baksha, that's the king. That's the real size of a king. King of heaven, not of England or of any place, but of heaven. And that's what you are. You are the citizens of that kingdom. To you, these things should be absolutely useless. The beauty of the matter should be seen, not the possession of it. Beauty is the comfort, not what you feel in the body like having comfortability. Beauty is so comforting, people do not know. How comforting is the beauty? And that, I'm sure, while you are celebrating his birth today, we glorify by accepting a kind of a mature spirit, a spirit in which you are dedicated, in which you do not demand anything but you give. You do not ask for anything but you give. Even today I receive letters from people saying that, please, I want a job, can you help me? Will you pray? All sorts of things like that. Will you pray? All sorts of things like that. It can be every sort of a nonsense. Of course, I mean, one can have all that kind of thing, but ask for one, and that is the spirit. And once you ask for that, that's the highest you have asked for. Then you don't want anything. The enjoyment is complete. So to celebrate his birth and to rejoice in that is to rejoice in our adequacy. If you are adequate, you do not hanker after your inadequacy, don't you? If you are complete, if you are full, if you are satisfied, you do not hanker, do you? So enjoy your adequacy, your completeness, your fullness, and your complete satisfaction. Enjoy that. Ultimately, all these things lead to some sort of a satisfaction. Of course, I don't know if you get any satisfaction out of that. But the real satisfaction that is within you is the spirit. Enjoy that. This is for yourself and for others. You are a comfort to others. It's not that anybody who talks to you will come and complain to me, "Mother, he has bitten me. I had a meeting with another scorpion. He bit me. I touched somebody and he hit me." Comfort. You are a thing of comfort. Believe him, you are. Comfort. So those who comfort others do not bother about their comfort. The shepherds, simple people, in this cold, imagine they were outside. They saw the vision of the angel. It can only be seen by people who are humble, who are leading a humble life. He appeared to them. And the another was vision to the wise. So only the humble people and the wise people, wisdom, common sense and wisdom. Those who are not wise can never understand. Those who are intelligent and intellectuals are not wise people at all. They're stupid. You know that they're stupid people. Wisdom. So the three wise men and the shepherd is another great symbolism. Those who will understand Sahaja Yoga. Simple people. Shepherds. And another are the wise. Only the wise can understand the star. So many must have seen the star. Wise men from the east. It's true. Eastern people are much more wiser than other people, no doubt about it. But why? Let's see why they are wiser. Eastern are wiser. Up to point. In your body, then east and west, if you see. East is left side. And west is right side. Eastern are the left side, nearer the heart. But not the easternmost are Japanese, horrible people. Japanese, horrible. Then all these people who are selling you these drugs and all that, the most of all. But those who know and are left side, the combination of knowledge and compassion. If there is no love, if there is no compassion, I mean, you just can't talk to that person. He's like a stick. I mean, in a dried stick, What vibrations can I give you? Just tell me. A dried stick, straight forward dried stick. You see. What vibrations I can give to a dried stick? There should be some sort of a greenery in it, isn't it? Little bit, at least. If it is too much of water also, it is spoiled. Can be rotten. But if it is a dry stick, straight forward, you know what I mean, dry sticks are, then how can you give vibrations to such a person? You cannot raise such a person. So first thing is love. And wisdom comes through love. Wisdom doesn't come through intelligence. It comes through love. When you love someone, you get the light of wisdom. By thinking you can never become wise. You can become stupid, absolutely stupid. But by loving, you can become very wise. When I see Sahaja Yogi suddenly say something, say extremely wise, something great. Suddenly, there's something says so sweet and so nice as it stands. The heart is opened up. The fragrance of wisdom comes from the heart, and that is symbolic. That three of them came. And they were who? Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha. They came to see Christ. Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha. See the vibration. Because they only can recognize. Not ordinary people. Romans. No. So they came. So we have to be humble and we have to be wise. Wisdom is such a diamond. It has so many facets that I cannot describe to you in this short time. One day I'll talk about wisdom. But it's all common sense. So sweet, so beautiful. Where to say what, how to change the subject, where to assert more, where to handle the situation in a strong way, is to where to be a gentleman and where to be uncouth, where to shout at people and where to be quiet and humble and sweet. All such a judgment, you see, is all that is wisdom, you see, is the center of gravity. And to achieve that, you have to give up your extreme behavior. Obstinacy is the first thing that should be given up. For all wisdom, obstinacy. Have a son of Christ, such a great, I mean, so confident, you know, feel Adharana, complete report is there. No problem of any kind. To have a son like him. Completely obedient, absolutely 100% obedience and humility and understanding of your being. No problem. You are all my sons, made after him, after the same pattern as I made Karuna. I'm proud of you, my children. Come up to it. And you have an example already created for you. Before you is Christ. See him. What a support it was. I never had any complaints of any kind. No opposite. He would never be upset. No question. He would never tell me I am upset. Never. This word doesn't exist in the dictionary of wise. You are never. How can you be upset when you are set once for all? This word must go from the dictionary of many Sahajogis who use it. Problems and upset. You solve the problem, give the solutions. No problems, only solutions. That's the way a son should be to a mother. That she can depend on. Absolutely. No problems there. Nothing. I mean, you have a son, one like Christ. What is there to worry about anything? Even the one word he said, behold the mother. It is a mantra. It is the greatest mantra that I use. When your attention is here and there, I just say that mantra to you as a command. And so humble, so humble. Behold. Behold doesn't mean look, no. It's a very humble way of addressing. Behold. Something glorious, something great. Behold it. Accept it. Understand. It was such a mutual understanding of support and love that should exist between us. No secretiveness, no formality, no exclusiveness. No exclusiveness. All enjoyments must be together. Now all your ideas of having separate enjoyments must be given up for a change. Holiday is when you are in the company of your, no more holiday, Sahajogis. All these things must be given up. This is all against Christ's behavior. He never had a holiday. Never. This is holiday. Holiday comes from the word holy day. Every day that is spent, every minute that is spent in the company of Christ is a holy day. So they must have brought it down, Christ to spirit and spirit to spirits and spirits to other things. I'm sure. That way human beings are very great at deriving at right points, you see, and jumping into ditches directly. So they must have done it so sweetly, beautifully. That's what it is, wisdom. Wisdom. All the time. Wisdom. Wise man is never cunning, never sharp. It's something I cannot describe. And who is the wisest of all? Is Sri Ganesha. Who is the embodiment of wisdom? Ask him for wisdom. He gives you the wisdom to ask him for wisdom. Today, I just think of how many Christmas I must have passed. I've never talked about Christ so much with that intimacy. Such a relationship. Such a relationship of so near and so far. Because he knew who I was. That awe, that respect, that humility is hard to find in any disciple, even in a disciple, in your own son. So close, but complete understanding. That oneness has to be developed. Gradually, we are all developing it, I know. But these are the days of speed and we have to speed up a little more in the right direction. So now, as desired by you, we have a white Christmas outside. Then, as you have desired that wash me and I shall be whiter than snow, is being blessed. Think of all the nice things we have done together and that we are going to together do it later on. That's how you solve your past and future problems. And Christ came on this earth to expand your present. So Christ, who is the present Christ, today, who is born in you, is to be lived out. Is not the Christ of the Bible, but the Christ of your heart, which is born within you, is to be looked out. Bible is so symbolic that it will take years and years for people to understand. It's too symbolic for you. But at least you can understand it. But other human beings cannot understand it. So one has to only understand through your own spirit. That is the Christ born within you, which must be looked after. Put him in a very soft heart. If you have thistles, he is a collective being. If you affect the collectivity, then he is affected. Look after him. So they say Merry Christmas. Is enjoyment for joy. Out of peace comes the joy, the light of joy, the happiness. I wish peace for the whole world, for the whole nation. To understand, to give up all the strifes, all the false battles for money and for power. All wrong ideas that they are different from each other. And come under the banner of Sahajiva and enter into the kingdom of God, where they are invited with all respect and love. I wish peace to all of them, to all the countries, all the human beings, in their families, in their hearts, with their children. With all of them, let there be peace. Let their heart emit peace. Their tongues speak with peace. Their eyes see nothing but peace. All this has to change. Tremendous change has to take place. The whole universe has to take a different turn. All that is hatred, hateful, ugly has to vanish, and the peace has to prevail. It is not the peace of the dead, but peace of the living that has to come, of the body. I bless all of you to be the channels of that peace, to be beautiful channels of that peace, to be glorious channels of that peace, to be great children of your mother, who is so proud of you. May God bless you. So you have to seek peace that is your mother. You all say that mantra. You say it. Ya Devi Sarvabhuteshu Shanti Rupena Swachita Namastase 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 Namo Namo. You say it once and then they should say it. Say it twice. It's a prayer.
Ya Devi Sarvabhuteshu Shanti Rupena Samasita Namastase 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 Namo Namah. Yadevi Sarva Bhuteshu Shanti Rupena Samstita. Namastasye, 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 Namo Namaha. Yadevi Sarva Bhuteshu Shanti Rupena Samstita. Namastasye, 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 Namo Namaha.
This is the mantra because the peace can come only through humility and forgiveness. Shama, that's why Christ is Shama. You say that for Christ.
Ya devi sarva bhuteshu kshama rupena samstita. Namastasye, 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 namo namaha. Ya devi sarva bhuteshu kshama rupena samstita. Namastasye, 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 namo namaha. Ya devi sarva bhuteshu kshama rupena samstita. Namastasye, 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 namo namaha.
Despite that, Agyas are saying, now can you take out Agyas? Those who are feeling hurt, please give up your Agyas now. Can you put your finger here for Agyas? Yeah, for the Jews. Now, all this is too much for Christmas. The most you can wash my hands and this and that.